No, you're not sitting down. You always have to listen to the director. He's got something.
Who's the head?
The boss. Right, now what's going to happen, okay? You're together like this. You can come over here, okay? You have to imagine, the audience have to imagine we have an elevator here, okay? And you're going to be the one. And imagine the things that are there. You want to see when you press buttons that it looks real.
Okay.
So you're going to go in. That's going to part like this. You're already in, going up to the top room. So you get in. It's quite crowded.
Okay.
So you said, excuse me, press the button. And what do you normally do when you press the button? Most people go and look up.
Yes.
To see where they're going. And I want to see you looking up, up here. And it's the door, and then you're going along. And suddenly, you will all do it together because it happens. You do that. The lift suddenly stops.
Suddenly.
It stops. Got that? Show stops. And you go. So there's a sudden. What's happened? Because it stopped. And there's a phone. Sorry, is there anybody there? We're stuck in the lift. So what this is, this is an exercise of slight claustrophobia. But it seems the more you're squashed like that, the more we believe that you're in this elevator. This I did when I was, how old were you? Eight, I was 11. So this is an exercise we did at drama school. So you get, and then you have to make it up yourself, talking, and you say, don't worry, we'll open the door a minute, and you pick up the phone and do this. So I'm going to leave it to you, for the audience to say, when are we going to get? So it will just happen naturally. Okay, and I'll have a set action, and the audience will have a look. Okay, and action.
Thank you, everybody.
We're on our way. Yeah, that was great going from the sort of fun thing, saying, oh, it's coming on.